Xia Chen, Professor of Accounting at School of Accountancy at Singapore Management University. My main research interest is financial reporting. In particular, I have several projects related to family firms and their financial reporting disclosure practices. Family firms usually are the firm where the controlling families hold a large chunk of shares and they have the company's interests at heart. If lots of family members are involved in the business, it basically means the families are committed to the business. So to make sure that the firm can succeed, sometimes they see the firm as something they can pass on to their future generation. So they do care a lot about creating value, making sure the firm succeeds. The purpose of my project is to help us better understand, you know, what's the impact of family control and ownership on firm's decision. And the company is basically following all the proper procedures and duties, whether it's actually a good thing for the other shareholders. Well, in some occasions, it actually can create problems. So what we find is, somewhat surprisingly, if you compare family firm with other firms, family firms actually have poorer internal control, but it's only for a small set of firms. If you look at corporate governance level, so they're less independent. So if you look at their board of directors, there are family representatives and there are fewer independent directors. You know, family members, they do bring benefits, they do create value for shareholders, but sometimes when they have a lot of power and this power are not limited by good internal control, it actually can be problematic. In such cases, actually, family firm members use different channels, different methods to seek rent. They basically benefit themselves at the cost of other shareholders. This suggests that investors as well as governments, regulators, they should pay more attention to internal control disclosure and internal control quality. If there's a combination of internal control problem and family dominant control, this can suggest there's some underlying problems that need to be limited. Since family firm is such a big part of the economy, better understanding the family firm is very important. I think especially for the emerging economy, like some of the Asian countries and China, because, you know, when a firm was initially founded, it always starts as a family firm. But over time, family members should understand the importance of corporate governance and also understand the importance of being able to pass the firm, to open up the firm to other shareholders and also to professional management talent. As researchers, we always hope our research funding has practical implications. So I do hope that the family firm need to realize that they need to introduce professional talent as they grow, as they become bigger, how to create value, how to have better governance, and how to contribute to the society.